I welcome you to this lesson. I'm teacher Katimbo Richard, teaching mathematics, primary 7. As I introduced in the lesson before this one, I introduced bearing as part of geometry. We did the theory part of it. Now we've gone practical and we are looking at scale drawing in the same bearing, that is a topic called geometry. And now we are starting. When you watch this lesson successfully, you'll then be able to answer all the activities on page 102 all the way to 104 of our workbook. Term 2P7, I say 192 all the way to 104 of our book. So practical part it is, and number one reads, Mpiji is 40 kilometers east of Gulu, and Lira is 30 kilometers south of Mpiji. So it's again, Mpiji is 40 kilometers east of Gulu, and Lira 30 kilometers south of Mpiji. Now, using a scale of 1 centimeter to represent 10 kilometers, draw an accurate diagram to show the location of these three towns. Now, the first thing we do in geometry, or in the practical geometry, is to draw a sketch. We always draw the sketch first, in order to accurately show the same three towns of Mpiji, Gulu, and Lira. Now, what's the use of the sketch? Sketch interprets all the statements that I've brought and shows what actual diagram is to look like. Now that it does those two, we sketch. We've got two words that we need to look at in this practical geometry, majorly scale drawing in bearing. One, the word of, and two, the word from. But of the two, the major word is from. So you should always look out for the word from, then the next town. So when you see the word from, that's why base, it will give you the base. When you say from Gulu, you just know base at Gulu. So if there's no word from, definitely there will be the word of. And now, like you see here, PG is 40 kilometers east of Gulu. So there's no from, but there's of. Where the word of, or a town that's preceded by the word of, is the town you base at first. So you draw a compass direction, because we say bearing is the location of a place from another. So we locate these places using a compass direction, and therefore we shall draw our first compass direction at Gulu. So we draw at Gulu like this, and show the north, and then they are saying Mpiji is located 40 kilometers east of Gulu. Now this is Gulu, west and east of the same Gulu. So this is the east, south, west and north, so east of Gulu. That's why the east line, the east direction, has been prolonged. So you prolong that one to locate Mpiji, so that Mpiji 40 kilometers east of Gulu, like the statement suggests. Mpiji is 40 kilometers east of Gulu. First, draw the first compass direction at Gulu. Please locate the east of Gulu, prolong the east direction, so that you find Mpiji along that east direction. So that is 40 kilometers east of Gulu. That's where Mpiji is. Now Mpiji is here. Always show the arrow and the north. North must ever be shown, and they should always show the arrow so that that idea of parallelness comes in, like we did understand in the first lesson of theory. And now we are at PG, then read. And Lira, Lira is 30 kilometers south of PG. Now that PG is here, then prolong the south so that Lira is located. So Lira is 30 kilometers south of PG. So write the 30 kilometers here and then write Lira, having drawn another compass direction. It should be noted that both Lira and PG have got a common north. You don't need to show another north. So they've got a common north. And then two, much as a sketch is never accurate, one must draw these lines considerably, considering the distances. Look at 30 and 40. 40 is the longer journey, so let it be longer than the 30 kilometer journey, much as not accurate, so that you have fully interpreted and shown the location of the three towns, and this is what the actual diagram is going to look like. Now they are saying, using a scale, what is it going to represent 10 kilometers? Draw an actual diagram to show the three towns. Now, as you know, on paper, you cannot measure a kilometer accurately. That's why the idea of the scale comes in, that every centimeter you're going to show that your diagram will be representing 10 kilometers on ground. So use that scale. That's why we say scale drawing in geometry, in particular in bearing. So go 10 kilometers to be represented by 1 centimeter of paper. What about 40 kilometers? Yeah, to be represented by 40 divided by 10 centimeters of paper. Cancel by 10 and by 10. So that 40 kilometers are represented by 4 centimeters on paper. Then go, still use the scale, 10 centimeters to be represented by 1 centimeter on paper. What about 30 kilometer journey? That's 30 divided by 10 centimeters on paper, so that you cancel, get 30 kilometers represented by 3 centimeters on a mere piece of paper. Now go to what your diagram, that's when use your geometrical instruments. Here, you have freedom to use a protractor to draw the perpendiculars. You have freedom as well to use a pair of compasses to draw those right angles. Accurately, get hold of your ruler and then start. Draw a straight line here that is horizontal, and now I say you have freedom to use a protractor to draw this perpendicular or right angle 90 degree accurately, because we said all these angles are 90s. So you have freedom as well to use a pair of compasses. So I've opted for the use of a pair of compasses. So do I put my pointer or the pair of compass in the middle here? I'll make an arc either side of that point, this way and that way. Make it once without adjustment. Mine adjusted a little. So without adjustment, and then remove, put on this arc. Adjust a little, I'm constructing 90 degrees. You're free to use the other way of constructing it. That's via the semicircular style. And now that the arcs are made, I'll get my ruler and then join through the intersection of the arcs. And as I said, through, so that we make a compass direction in the four cardinal points of north, south, east, and west. And then show the parallel to the next line or perpendicular you shall construct. And always show the north and then write the place. Gulu. This is Gulu. Place called Gulu. After Gulu is written, then you will prolong the east of Gulu to locate Mpiji. Put a ruler, put your ruler against the east, prolong it like that. It should be in line with the original, and then see what is to represent or what 40 kilometers are to be represented by. So the 40 kilometer journey is to be represented by 4 centimeters on the mere piece of paper, that is use of the scale, that is scale drawing in geometry. Go to a ruler and measure the said 4 centimeters that are representing the 40 kilometer journey. Please go to the centimeter scale and measure the said 4 centimeters. And then, having measured the 4 centimeters, you go to the place called Gulu. Place your point of imperial compasses there, and then make that arc. Let me test again. Say it 4 centimeters. Let me see whether I measured 4 or I missed a point 1 here. So please measure accurately, so that the 4 is measured well. So go and then mark off that length, 4 centimeters, and then remove your pair of compasses from the original line, and then write, I'm sure I've got a measure of 4 centimeters here, and it's under the word accurate. So I've written the 4 centimeters, then we have reached Mpiji, and you see a perpendicular cutting across that arc. So do you construct another 90 degree angle? I said you have freedom to use a protractor here, since the instructions tell us to draw. Okay, do construct 90 degrees. So make 2 arcs either side of that point, then we transfer the pointer to the drawn arc, then adjust a little, and then we make an arc here, and then transfer to the other second arc, and then draw. That arc. Now, when that arc is made, then you will get a ruler and then go through like that, through the intersection of the arcs, and then later the main arc, which marked off the PG or the 4 centimeters. And then show the north of the same town called Mpiji. Write Mpiji here. Please, at the intersection or in the middle, write Mpiji. That is in the middle. That's a town called Mpiji. And then look at the distance, which is 30 kilometers to be represented by 3 centimeters on a piece of paper. So you go to the ruler and measure 3 centimeters. Get hold of your pair of compasses, go to a centimeter scale on the ruler, go and measure a length which is required, the 3 centimeter length. Ensure I measure it properly, and then go to Mpiji town, and then be able to mark off that line. Mark off that 3 centimeter journey. You are free to prolong a little. And that way you will have drawn and shown the location. Now, this last perpendicular, you are free to use a protractor. You can use a protractor to measure that angle. Actually, only that here hardly be measured. Okay, place the protractor properly here and then measure that perpendicular. No, I'm teaching these 7 members who can measure the angle of 90 properly. So 90 is here. So that get a ruler and join through that, put at that arc, and then draw a perpendicular properly. And now you have that line, and now I've reached leader, right leader here. Now it is of 3 centimeters. Write the 3 centimeter journey and circling. You will have shown the 3 turns actually. So that's how we use the scale given bearing to locate places. For bearing means the direction of a place from another. And now it's fully done, so nothing else. Then we go to example number 2 for today. Example number 2 reads: Town M is 60 kilometers northeast of Town N, and Town L is 80 kilometers from Town N on a bearing of 120 degrees. Using a scale of 1 centimeter that represents 20 kilometers, draw an actual diagram to show the positions or the location of these 3 towns. Now, I say it, we care about 2 words, one from, another one of. So let's see the first statement says, Town M is 60 kilometers northeast of Town N. So here I don't have the word from, but I have of. So draw the first compass direction at Town N. So we draw Town N compass direction and then show the north. And we locate Town M, 60 kilometers northeast. We go northeast. East is this way, so we go northeast of this town N. So northeast is between north and east. So this is the line, which is 60 kilometers of Town N to locate Town M. So write Town M, having drawn the compass direction and shown the arrow as well as the north. And this is Town M, that is 60 kilometers northeast of Town N. And then read the next statement, which is connected to the first one by this conjunction and Town L is 80 kilometers from Town N, and Town L is 80 kilometers from Town N on a bearing of 120 degrees. So we can locate a place using the direction, like northeast, southwest, mentioned, but a few. We can as well locate a place using a number. This time we are going to locate town L from town N, but at a number of 120. So look at the word from. From town N means base at N, and then move an angle of 120 degrees. Remember, in the previous lesson, we talked about true bearing. True bearing is the kind of bearing that is measured from the north clockwise and in 3 degrees. So that's why 120 degrees is already in 3 degrees, and therefore we determine it from the north of the same town where the word from is. They are saying from town N. So from north of N clockwise, 110 degrees, we shall reach the road that connects to town L. So, like we said in the previous lesson, that whichever angle is given, you will only determine its movement and its effect when you know how many quarter turns or how many 90s it bears. So the question is, how many 90s and 120s? Only one. So you first move the first 90, it means it goes beyond that east direction and goes towards the south. So therefore you get 120 degrees minus the moving 90, and thereby getting 30 degrees. So it means 90 plus an angle of 30, you get 120. So therefore we add on another angle which is smaller than a half of the next 90. You know, half of the 90 is a 45, but this 30 to be added is less than a half. So being that it's less than 45, then it is having a small effect onto the next 90. Now you have to have a small effect, don't make a half of the next 90. So you draw a line going that side or moving towards town L, and indeed you reach town L. And whichever town you draw, show the compass direction, show the north, and the arrow shows parallelness. So these three lines are parallel because of those arrows you see, and it's mandatory or compulsory for you to put the north, because it must then. So then write 80 kilometers, considering the 80 kilometer journey in comparison with the 61, please ensure this 80 kilometer line is longer than the 60 kilometer journey, because actually it is. So ensure it's longer. And now you show the whole 120 because of the additional 30 from the east to the road. So this is 30, starts from here, and the 120 starts from the north all the way to the road. So show both that 90 plus 30, you get the whole of it as 120 degrees, and the sketch is done. And now we go use of the scale. You say using a scale of 1 centimeter represent 20 kilometers. You say 20 kilometers are to be represented by 1 centimeter. What about the 60 kilometer journey? That's 60 divided by 20 centimeters. Cancel very well by 2 1s by 2 3. So 60 kilometers are to be represented by 3 centimeters on a mere piece of paper. Then work out for the 80 kilometer journey, which can never be accurately be shown on paper. We only show what is to be represented by. So we said 20 centimeters are to be represented by 1 centimeter. What about 80 kilometers? They are to be represented by 80 divided by 20 in centimeters. You cancel by 10 by 10, by 2 ones, by, that's 8 divided by 2 get 4. So 80 kilometers are to be represented by 4 centimeters on paper. Then resort to what is called arch rate diagram. Arch rate diagram. Now we start. We shall start in town N, where we started from. Get your ruler, like this. Draw a horizontal line Now we are going to construct all just near draw perpendicular. If you want, you can just draw a perpendicular without construction. So, meaning, get the place of origin. Place of origin, like this. And place your protractor properly and measure a 90 degree angle. Indeed, you put a dot, measure 90 degree angle, get the ruler. Since you have been taught to draw, so we are drawing. Draw that 90 degree angle, the point is here. You are then going through the original properly. You may not reach that far, but go through once and then show the north. And now this is town N. Name it. You can even name it up here. Town N. Remember, it's capital because the name of the town. It's a proper noun, that is. And now you are determining the northeast, because they're talking about northeast. Northeast is a point in between north and east. Therefore, being in between, it needs to bisect an angle. Remember, we said bisect an angle is to divide it into two equal parts so that it is halved. So we are going to bisect that 90 so that we have a 45 degree angle. Make that arc as well as that one. That arc, it means the other line needs to be prolonged a little, and then you bisect. I said put here, make that arc and that arc. Now put on the arc properly and make that arc. Then go to this other arc, please, and make that middle arc. Get a ruler and then join through the intersection to the nucleus here. Draw properly. Like that. Now, that is the actual northeast of town M. So, we are locating town M now. So, we said 60 kilometers are divided by 3 centimeters. Go to the ruler and measure the same 3 centimeters. 3 centimeters, go to the centimeter scale. Go to the centimeter scale and measure. 3 centimeters, please carefully measure 3 centimeters. Mine is measured. Let me hope you are doing the same. Practical geometry means we want to do as the teacher does, not just listening. Ensure you are doing what I'm doing. So you mark off the measured 3 centimeters and write that you are sure you have measured 3 centimeters and here. So write 3 centimeters along that line. And now, normally the turn is our area of contention. So you must know what is contained in the parallel lines, majorly the alternate interior angles when dealing with bearing and practical bearing. So you must know that this angle is 45 and so is this one. This angle is also 45 and so is this one. So to bring the accuracy of east and west lines or line, you must measure an angle of 45 degrees. And therefore, we measure that angle so that we turn. So this angle here will be equivalent to this angle up here because there will be alternate interior angles. So we go to our main line here, place the protractor and measure the said 45 degrees. The angle down here is the angle to that direction also. It should be alternate interior angles like we said in parallel lines in the same topic, geometry. That's why you are taught parallel lines first before the bearing itself, because we knew they would be used. So we measure 45 degrees, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 45 is here, 45 degrees. Please, you measure them basing on the original line, that line of bone for northeast. And then take a reading up to 45. And now we get your ruler. Place that said ruler here. And ensure you can connect through that point. The point is here where 45 is, but you don't need to reach there. So that you get the east and west lines accurately drawn. Now draw through the intersection here. You can able to stop there, and that is the accurate east and west lines. This angle here being 45 is equal to that angle there, 45. In so doing, you have brought another parallel line parallel to this east and west line as well. And now we get a protractor, since we chose to use that one today or for this particular number. Then we measure a new perpendicular, a new right angle, a new 90 degree angle. Place your protractor in such a way that the 90 line goes to the arc, and then this line that is on your protractor, that black one, covers the east and west line. And then take a reading of 90. The 90 is ever in the middle here, and is the perpendicular. Then remove, get your ruler, place your ruler properly such a way that you can go through that very point. The point is here. I don't want to draw up there. It was used to just get the guidance to the perpendicular. So you draw up there, show the north of that town called M. So write town M. Town M. Now we continue. We are then locating another town, town L, but basing at N again. This time using an angle. This angle is 120 degrees. Place the protractor town N, and then draw that angle. You are drawing that angle M. So can we put this side so that I can measure that angle properly? So I'm pressing it here. Press it properly so that you can measure that angle. Okay, measure that angle. So ensure you place it against the first original compass direction. Take a reading up 120 clockwise. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 100, 90, 100, 110, 120. 120 as an angle is here. So you are to draw a line, a straight line. Since you have measured that straight line, then you have to return the ball in a straight way and then join accordingly. So get a ruler, we use this short one, and join accordingly. So join that way and to turn in properly. Say I'm very sure I've measured 120 degrees. This time the 30 may not be written, it is only necessary the turning point. So right here 120 degrees measured using a protractor, and actually, and we say it, the 80 kilometers are divided by 4 centimeters on actual diagram, just on paper. So we measure 4 centimeter length onto our ruler on the centimeter scale. Here it is. I will then go to the said town enemy and then mark off that measured 4 centimeters and then write it here on the line that I'm very sure this is 4 centimeters. And now I need to turn. That's when the 30 is going to be used. You measure 30 centimeters down here, down here, and put our protractor again so that it can fit. What we don't have here is space, so get our protractor and then do measure that 30 centimeters to have a proper turn along this line. Take a reading and now go 0, 10, 20, 30. So our 30 has come here. Then put a ruler and then connect through so that it is parallel also. Connect properly. That's our 30 measured. And now we've maintained an accurate east and west line. So this time round, you get your protractor again. You measure R90 at that very point. At that very point, measure R90. Since you chose to use a protractor in this one, so put a point where 90 is. It is here. So the point is there. Get the ruler and go through the same point and make the proper compass direction. Proper compass direction for that same point. And this is the north of the said town. Which town is L? Right here, town L. And in so doing, you will have drawn the location of the three towns on an actual diagram. That's how we have the drawings on scale, called scale drawing in geometry. So we shall then look at the last example today. The last example today reads, town Q is 50 kilometers west of town P, and town R is 40 kilometers from town P on a bearing of 150 degrees. Using a scale of what's going to represent 10 kilometers, draw an actual diagram showing the three towns of Q, P, and R. Now, like I said before, we start by sketching. Here, we look at the two words I said from or off. Let's see the first one. First statement reads, town Q is 50 kilometers west of town P. We use off. of town P, west of town P. So we need the west part or west direction of P. Therefore, we draw this P in the east so that the west is seen. So we draw our town P here, show the north, and then go prolong the west of P. The west of P, go west and locate 50 kilometers and then show. This is town Q that's located 50 kilometers west of P. 50 kilometers west of P. Be careful about west and east. So town Q is located 50 kilometers west of P. And that way you have interpreted properly. Then C, let's locate town R. And town R is 40 kilometers from town P. We are basing at P. The word is from. From P. So go to town P. And then locate the place this time using a number 150. How many full 90s are in 150? Because when you count in 90s, the first one is 90. The second is 180. And as we see, 150 is less than 180. So the second 90 is not fully taken. So therefore, we first move 190 that has come out. Then for the sidewalk and say 150 minus 90 already moved. We have got to add on 60. So at 90 plus 60. So the 60 is a greater angle than 45. Meaning, you know, 45 is a half of the next 90 or any 90. So therefore we affect this next 90 more than a half. We take a greater part so that this 60 goes beyond a half. A half is somewhere here, so it goes beyond 45. And then show the whole of this angle from the north clockwise, please, after the road as 150 because of the addition of 60 onto the first 90. So show both 150 as well as 60, and then that's the road leading us to another town. Town R. So show the town by mere draw of the compass direction and show the north, or show the arrow to show parallelness, thereby making the roads or each of the roads here a transversal. That's the language about parallel lines. If you have been following my lessons or our lessons as trained up in general, so that's town R. And now show them R, and so doing, you have drawn a sketch which shows what the actual diagram is to look like. And now we are using the said scale of 1 centimeter to represent 10 kilometers. So the 50 kilometers as well as 40 kilometers cannot be shown accurately on paper. That's why we use the scale, so that we actually use centimeters instead of kilometers. So 10 centimeters are represented by 1 centimeter. What about 50 kilometers? They are to be represented by 50 kilometers divided by 10, answer in centimeters, cancel zeros, and then get 50 kilometers are represented by 5 centimeters on a mere piece of paper. And now go. 10 kilometers are represented by 1 centimeter. What about 40 kilometers? They are represented by 40 divided by 10 centimeters, thereby getting 4 centimeter journey on a mere piece of paper. Now we are then to show 5 and 4 for 50 kilometers and 40 kilometer journeys respectively. And now go after the diagram. We start. We shall again use a protractor this time again. So I said you are free to use a pair of compasses like I did in the first example, or use a protractor. And of course, a pair of compasses to mark off just. But for the angles, you can use a protractor. And now we draw a straight line. Get your ruler. You draw a straight line just like this. And then mark the point where you are going to base your protractor. Measure 90 degrees at that very point, please. 90 is just in the middle here,
put a dot against 90
and remove. Get your ruler
and then look at that point where 90 was demarcated or shown, and then draw that angle of 90 so that it's perpendicular to make a compass direction, go through properly, and then show the north
in that way. You have your town Chu.
You can write it up here. Town Chu. Now, prolong the west.
Go to the west. Sorry, prolong the east of town Chu because it's located in the east of P. So we go.
Prolong the east. So you can prolong the east in this form. Draw once and use thin lines.
Ensure your pencil
is sharp enough not to draw thick lines. So having done that,
you look at the 50 kilometer representation. So it's represented by 5 centimeters on mere piece of paper. You go to your ruler and measure the 5 centimeter length. 5 centimeter length, like that. Mine is measured. What about yours?
Then mark it off. Put a Chu at the middle point there. You make that arc
and show
you have measured 5 centimeters without fear. So that one is already written. So now that you have written 5 centimeters, you are going to locate town P.
Get your protractor again.
Measure your 90 again. Ensure I press it properly. And then put your dot against 90 here.
And now get a ruler again.
And then join, since you are taught to draw, you have freedom to use a protractor to measure all the 90s as well as other angles. So show this is the north, this type of point of town P. Refer to the sketch and see which towns you are to write against which points. So town P. Show town P properly. And now you are going to measure an angle of 150 degrees at town P in this form, making the north the origin, and then place your protractor in that regard. Then take a reading all the way to 150 degrees. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150. 150 is here. Put a point, please, and remove. Put your ruler, against that point, and join to point P, or to town P. Having done that, join accordingly and go up to that point P, town P, and say, I'm sure perfectly measured 150 degrees, and here do I limit
that angle 150 degrees. And now we follow the sketch every time. So this is 40 kilometers on ground to be represented by 4 centimeters on paper. Get hold of that pair of compasses, go to a ruler on the centimeter scale and measure the said 4 centimeters. And here, do I measure mine? Do the same. Measure 4 centimeters on paper. Sorry, on the ruler, please, on the centimeter scale.
And then you are obliged to marking off. Put at P and then mark off.
Now, if you see the line is short, then prolong it so that you can go through that drawn line, that drawn arc. So let it go through properly. It's in a straight way. Ensure it's straight. Now you are on your left with the compass direction at town R. And now you must then use this 60 here. So the 60 here, you see here, is the one that brings the east and west lines from this road. So you get a protractor and measure the angle here, which is the 60, like 60 is, because they are alternate interior angles, put against the road and turn accordingly so that the 60 is respected. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. And now the 60 is here. I'll put my note here against 60. And then I would have obtained the east and west lines that are parallel. So that line will be parallel to this one. So put your ruler, please, in a straight way. Ensure you can connect this point through this arc, and don't actually connect. Leave it like that. So east and west line is accurate there. And now get your protractor at last. You measure that perpendicular, which is a 90. Place it properly, like you were taught since P4, how to measure an angle using the protractor. And it is the same content here, or the same way. So do it in the same way, the 90 is there. So get a ruler and then draw a line through that point, and you have drawn a perpendicular. So through that point, I say it, let it connect properly, and that will be having that north of the last town called Town Ara. You can write it here, you can as well write it here, or here. So depending on your wish. Town Ara, which must be capitalized because a proper noun. In that way, you would have shown the three towns on an actual diagram. In short, that's how we use scale drawing in geometry or in bearing, and locate different places. For bearing means the location of a place from another using the compass direction, like we've seen. Teacher Katimbo Richard has taught you that much. For more information about the same, please call Teacher Katimbo on 0776251655. Alternatively, you can use the Airtel line 0757233066. Otherwise, that is the end of this lesson. We meet in the next episode. Please stay safe.